up, see a new episode of Pick of the Week, and find out when the Letty and the Skeletons will happen. All that and more next on Bash TV News.
Welcome back. Your dreams were your ticket out. Welcome back to the old place that you laughed about. Well, the names have all changed since you hung around, but those dreams have remained and they've turned around. Who'd have thought they'd lead ya?
Who'd have thought they'd lead ya?
Back here where we need ya.
Back here where we need ya.
Yeah, the tease him a lot, cause we got him on the spot. Welcome back.
Welcome back, welcome back, welcome back.
Welcome back to Bash TV News.
Hello, welcome to Bash TV News for Thursday, October 8th, day 3. I'm Paige Childs. Please rise for the pledge of the flag, followed by a moment of silence. Welcome back to Bash Group B students. For everyone new to the school, Bash TV News is our high school's daily news program, which consists of school announcements, sports news, weather, and special programs such as In the Hall and Pick of the Week. While we are in a hybrid schedule, Bash TV News will be streaming live on our YouTube channel, so students at home have the chance to watch the announcements. We will leave the shows up on the YouTube so that you can also view them later. Some important dates to note, October 12th, Columbus Day, is a regular school day for students, so make sure you come to school if you're in Group A or attend virtually if you are Group B. Mid-quarter is October 14th, and October 28th is Senior Presentation Day, starting at 12:30. Seniors should check the Career Portfolio section of the high school website for more information about senior presentations. Now let's go to Griffin Wien in our sports center to see what's happening in our sports world.
Hi, guys. So yesterday in Bash Sports, we had girls tennis win their match 7-0 over Upper Marion. And girls volleyball beat Pottsgrove 3-0. Coming up today, we have girls varsity golf at 3 p.m. against Phoenixville home. We also have girls soccer at 5 p.m. against O&J Roberts. And last, we have boys soccer away at O&J Roberts. That's it for sports. Back to you. Next, we have Pick of the Week.
Hello, and welcome back for week 4 of Pick of the Week. I'm your host, Haley Stutzman. So last week, the Steelers-Titans game unfortunately got canceled due to coronavirus, but we had the teachers pick a new game, and we gave them the Browns versus Cowboys, and they picked the Browns. I promise there was no cheating involved, but let's take a look at the standings.
The teacher team leads as the Browns defeated the Cowboys 49-38, and Kansas City beat the Patriots after Cam Newton tested positive for COVID. The student team still falls behind with Tom Brady dominating the Chargers and Philadelphia finally finding a win and placing themselves first in the NFC East.
All right, here we go again. Pick of the week. Last week, I think we went undefeated, so it was a good week. This week, I'm going to introduce our guest picker. This is brilliant veteran teacher. I mean, great family man, Mr. Freeze. Mr. Freeze, did I cover everything you wanted me to? Okay, right. I'm sorry. He's also got movie star looks. He's 6'1", and he can bench press 450 pounds. So all around great guy, Mr. Freeze. How you doing?
I'm doing great.
Good to see you.
Yeah, thank you so much for having me here. I can bench press that with one arm. You should have mentioned that.
But
yeah, that's all right. So I'm very excited to be in the Pick of the Week. I used to do it. You and I used to do it decades ago. It was just you and I. I know that this is like a five-minute segment, and Connor McNeil will talk 8 minutes and 12 seconds of the – because he's got a lot to say, whether he knows what he's talking about or not.
Man.
But he doesn't. All right, so this is probably an easy game because being from Pennsylvania, it's really important to support Pennsylvania teams. So obviously I'm going to go with – the Steelers. They're so much better than the Eagles. I know the Eagles are going to the Super Bowl now that they won one game and they're in first place because the NFC East is horrible. And the Cowboys, which is my team, are just as bad as all those other teams. However, Steelers are good. And as far as the Chargers and the Saints, I think The Chargers are looking better, and they had a good game last week, but I still think they lost their running back. So I still think the Saints and Drew Brees, I think, is a little younger than me, but not much. I think they're going to win. So I'm going to go with the Saints and the Steelers, and the Eagles are going to lose again.
Awesome picks. Great teacher. Told you.
Thank you very much.
And welcome back to week four of Pick of the Week. I'm Connor McNeil here with Ava Lind. Ava, how are you doing today?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing pretty freaking fantastic. My Birds won on Sunday. But let's get right into it. I have the Bears, Buccaneers. I'm going with the Bucs. Tom Brady was stellar on offense. And I think he can do the same thing and reperform against the Bears defense. Ava, you have Dallas and New York. Who are you taking?
I'm going to take the Giants because I hate the Cowboys.
I couldn't agree with you more, Ava. Nobody likes the Cowboys anymore besides Mr. Freeze. And we all know how that is. And we'd like to thank you all for watching. With that being said, I'm Connor McNeil here with my good friend Ava Lind. And we'll see you next week for week five of Pick of the Week.
Are you interested in being part of a televised student discussion show? Then Insight is for you. Insight is a student-run club in which an hour discussion show is recorded every month and aired on the district's cable channel, as well as the internet. Topics range from current events to entertainment to school issues to anything the club wants to talk about. If you would like to be a part of this club, come to the first Insight meeting on October 15th at 3 p.m. in the TV studio. If you would like to attend the meeting through Zoom, email Mr. Tracaski at btracaski@boyertownasd.org for a Zoom invite link. For the past week, Mrs. Bramble and Mrs. Witzfalcone's life skills students in Mr. Schiff's 7th grade adaptive tech ed class were tasked with creating a device from everyday materials that would protect an egg from breaking when dropped from the top of Memorial Stadium. On Tuesday, 5 of the egg drop designs were tested with varying results. The students had a great time and learned about gravity, speed, and inertia as well, as varying tools and safety procedure.
One, ready? Just let go.
Oh, man.
Oh, let go.
Oh, man. Whoa, you got it on the bullseye. Oh, shit.
One.
Oh, man.
Hey, it almost went right on the top.
Very good job.
All hit hard.
All right, I'll tell you what, let's head back in. We'll cut them open and we'll see how the damage is.
Here you go, Tosh.
Oh, man!
Oh! Megan's cracked! There you go. Show the camera.
Yeah.
Good job,
yeah.
Natasha!
Yeah, Natasha!
Amy!
All right, Aiden.
Yours is good.
Yeah, buddy, yours made it.
You saw it. He smiled.
Okay, good. He knows it was his.
I think it's
good.
It looks like it's good.
It looks like it's good.
Did it make it?
Yeah.
That one hit right on the corner.
Oh, nice.
Hey, all right, everybody. Yeah. Good job. Good job.
TV News Flash Weather.
Hi, this was already here, so press the button. The temperature is 52 degrees, and humidity is 70%, and wind speed is 4 miles per hour. At 12, it's going to be 61 degrees with sun. At 3, 63 degrees with sun, and 6 p.m., it'll be 59 degrees with sun. Thursday, it's a high of 63, low of 43 with big sun. Friday, high of 68, low of 54, sunny. Saturday, high of 79, low of 57 with part sun. And Sunday, high of 68, low of 59, and it's the rains. Back to you guys.
And mark your calendars for Friday, October 23rd, because we will be performing the 19th annual Lighting of the Skeletons right now. As you can see, they are all ready to go, and they are socially distanced and wearing masks. So tune in on the 23rd. You will not want to miss it. That's all for the edition of Bash TV News. I'm Paige Childs. Have a great day.
Toss.
keep on dancing all through the night. We're gonna keep on doing it right. We're gonna keep on.